Hello world, welcome to this tilt shift video where we will explain you how to make a fake tilt shift effect with your drone and Final Cut Pro. The basic effects should be applicable to all NLE video editing programs. However, I will add a small bonus at the end of this video, especially for Final Cut Pro. I am not going to explain what is tilt shift effect. There are plenty of tutorials about tilt shift online, and I will put some links of good videos in the description. It's almost impossible to make a tilt shift effect with a drone, unless you have a Bello camera or a tilt shift lens on your drone. This is hardly possible. However, it's fairly easy to create the dollhouse effect, which is normally a result of the tilt shift photography. That basically means we have an out of focus top and bottom, or left or right, but usually top and bottom, and some color grading. This is what we're gonna do today. What I have done in the video you see here is I have placed my big drone, my Inspire 2, focusing at the junction. It's very important that the drone stays as stable as possible. And then it should look down in an angle of about 45 degrees. This gives you the best result where you don't need to do a lot of editing afterwards. Because one of the effects we will add, it is very important that you take a very, very long shot. My shots are always 8 to 10 minutes, just like this is what you see here. Unfortunately, when I shot those images as you see here, there was no sun. Also, it was about to start raining. That's why everything is fairly gray. Of course, you can compensate that later on in post-production by color grading, but that doesn't make it easier. We're not going into that kind of detail, but I'll show you how to do it if you want. To have a good quality image, you will see that although it is a very stable drone, there is always some movement. That's why it is very convenient if you have a good stabilizer on your editing program. And I mean a really good stabilizer. I will show you why and how. Welcome in Final Cut Pro. Okay, this is the footage we have used and what we will use now for this sample. So this is my drone. Here I'm about 40 meters away from the junction and about 40 meters high, a little bit less. So the angle is somewhere between 40 and 45 degrees. It's a standard 15mm X5S camera on the Inspire 2, and this is the image we will have. As you can see, it is fairly gray, and the reason it's gray is because D-Log, or a special RAW format from DJI. I can show you. This is the video scope. We will take this away. This is the video scope. So basically, this tells you how the image is built up. Here you can see I have nothing, and here I have nothing. So that means we first have to make this into a normal color space. We can do that by the wheels, but I prefer to do it by the curves. Okay, this is the Luma, and this is the RGB Luma Parade. So first we go bring this up to about 100%. So it should not go over 100, it can go a little bit, but it should not do. Then we will bring also the shadows down. Now you see you get a completely different image. Also, we can take the midtones a little bit down as well. So we just take a little bit down. Or we can take it up, you see now you get very color. So this is basically how you can play with your image. So I think this is sharpest what we can get. So if you look, this is with color grading, this is without. You see the difference? So even if you have RAW format, this is how you can do. Later on, we're gonna play a little bit with the colors, but for now, I'm happy with this. So we take away the color parade. All right, so we have the footage here. You can see here it's 5 minutes 27 because I already took some off, which we will not use. So the first thing we have to do is speed up. So there's a couple of ways to do that. So I will say fast, we start with 8 times. Now you see that we have 8 times. The speed is fast 800%. That means it's 8 times the speed of normal. This is still not enough, I can tell you by now. But you see, now you get this effect. So we go make it a little bit faster. So we go here. We say custom. And we change this in 1000%. That means 10 times faster. Now you see that almost 6 minutes is going back to a little bit over 30 seconds. That's why it's important you have a lot of footage. Of course it needs to render because it's 4K. And this takes some time. But we get the effect that we want. What is very clear now is if you, this is my car, you see that although the Inspire 2 is a very stable drone, you see my car is moving like hell. So that's why it's important that your drone footage is as stable as you can, but we still need to stabilize a little bit. So let's do that first. As you can see, my bar is finished. That means it's rendered. Now I can play it. So if I play, watch my car. So we cannot use that. So now we're gonna stabilize it. We go to my effects. Here is the stabilization app. So now I first need to stabilize. I say I want to have a smooth cam. So you see it's analyzing for dominant motion. Okay, the rendering is finished. And we go over to tripod mode. That is basically the same as tracking, but now it will focus on some points in the image and it will stabilize on that. So basically now we have a very stable image. And if you look to my car, it's hardly moving. So this is maybe the most important step in the process. All right, let's go on. Now we go add some effects. And we're gonna start with the blur. So here we have focus, which we will add here. Now you can see already a little bit what is going to happen. So if we hide these, so what we need to do now is we need to make it white because we need to have the whole image. You can see the whole image and the height is about good, maybe a little bit more. Something like this. Mount is good. We will soften a little bit. We still want to see the car, so we should not make it too. So, now if we look, we have this. That all looks good. Now we're gonna add some colors. Okay, everything is rendered. So the first thing we go to do is now we go sharpen the image. So I drag the sharpen on and we add a little bit more. maybe something. Be always careful not to overdo. It just doesn't work. Then one thing that always looks very good to me is... I take the cartoon image. Now you get a little bit different effect. It just makes it a little bit more poppy, if you know what I mean. Then the next effect I'm gonna add is... teal and orange. It's a little bit trial and error. You have to find yourself what works best for you. So basically, we have now all the effects on the image we want. Now we start playing with the colors. So first we go to the color board. And of course, if we play, we need to have exposure basically is good. Saturation is also good. What we need is the color. This is the highlights. This is the midtones. This is the shadow. And this is the master. So I think the highlights are a little bit too much. And we want to have a little bit more reddish highlight. Not too much, but we can... You see, it's a little bit playing. I think this is going to look better. So you see, this is what I mean. Now we also can go maybe a little bit to the curves. Let's take this one. So the problem here is that you increase everything too much. So what we can try, this is just try out. This is the red. It's gonna make it a little bit more pink. So we're gonna add two control points here and here. And we're gonna increase a little bit the pinkiness. I think this looks a lot better. So if we now draw the whole thing back. Of course, we need to render first. Let's do that first. Okay, the rendering is finished. Let's see how it works. So, I think this looks nice. Basically, that is the whole trick. There is some extra things you can do with color grading, but for me, so far it looks good. Maybe we should add a little bit more on the blur. Color curves too don't work, so let's take them off. What I don't need, I take off. So we have a little bit sharpen here. See, that directly has an influence on the color. You know, it's getting a little bit more poppy now. So let's focus here. I think this looks fine. This looks actually good. So, I think we're gonna leave it like this. And we go edit some little bit more. Okay, so far, so good. I have promised you a small bonus. Here you see the plan. It's the same mission. I have already done that. The only thing I have done is I stabilized it and I have made it shorter. So to just cut down on all the things I said before, I have made a small addition for you. Just need to find it. This is called the Oebo tilt shift. Just put it on top. Make it a correct length. And now you see, I have, with one small app, I have basically all the same things. I have the correct settings, I have the correct color, I have the mist, which if you want, you can change. You have all your settings here, so you can make it bigger, smaller, you can do it on an angle, you can add a focus, cartoon amount. We need to have a car to see. We have added a little grain. You can change the contrast a little bit if you want. I have added some color which you can change. See, you have a little bit of grain that usually works a little bit better. With this, you can change everything you want with some sliders. And of course, I will upload it to my server and I put a link below so you can download it for free. Have fun with it, and if there's any questions, let me know.